Hi Harpers, I'm Tiffany Schaefer from TiffanyHarpAndSong.com, here to empower you to arrange and play Celtic music. Today I'm going to teach you a tune that is new to me. It's actually the same melody as a Carolan tune, Carolan's Lament, but it's also used for a very sad Christmas carol called The Holly and the Ivy Girl. Not to be confused with The Holly and the Ivy, a much peppier song. So because this is an O'Carolan tune, you really could play this as an instrumental any time of year that you need some slow, calming sort of music. Today I'm going to teach you the melody and some fingering to use, whether you're more of a beginner or a more advanced harper. Now I've seen this melody around in E minor, I've seen it in D minor. I decided to put it in B minor to make it more friendly towards those who don't have flats, and also to make it a more singable key in case you want to sing the words to this. I'm going to link a website below where you can read about this song and read the lyrics. And in speaking of singing, if you do want to sing it, my patrons are getting a bonus this month. It's a sheet of the first verse of this song written out so you can sing it, along with a way to adapt some of the patterns I've arranged just for harp and voice. Very easy, very small harp friendly, all written out so you can sing it. And that version is available exclusively to patrons, so make sure you click the link below to find that. But whether you're a patron or not, you can buy my instrumental arrangement of this. I've arranged the first verse easy and the second verse for more intermediate players, and you can hear what that sounds like by clicking the video up there. Always lots of goodies in the description, so make sure you click show more and read there. And let's learn the melody for Carolan's Lament or The Holly and the Ivy Girl. All right, so remember we are in the key of B minor or D. So we need all our Fs and Cs to be sharp, everything else natural. If you want to hear how this whole arrangement sounds with the beginner and the intermediate played one right after the other, you can watch the playthrough video. Those are always linked below in the description of these tutorials, and they always come out on YouTube the week before the tutorial, so you can find that there. Otherwise, I'm going to put a timestamp here on the screen for you to go ahead and skip ahead to the end of this, where we'll play the whole melody slowly together. But for now, let's start at the beginning. So I'm going to show you first a couple different ways to do the fingering on this. You might find it easier if you are more of a late beginner. I'll show you a couple different ways you can try that. And then we're going to go through some slightly different changes you could do, and some ornaments if you're maybe a more advanced player. So you can play this either in this octave, if you like it high, or if you have a small harp. You could also play it down here, if you have a larger harp and more room to play with the chords. For now, I'm going to show you up high here, and we're going to start with D, E, F, 3, 2, 1, fingers 3, 2, 1. I'll play a line, and then we'll go through it. So those two lines are very similar. I'm going to start by breaking down the first one. 3, 2, 1 on D, E, F. And here's where you'll float away. If you're reading the sheet music that I have for sale, you will notice that there's fingering for the beginner one. And there's also a little arrow pointing up. And that's where you can lift off and float away and relax and replace. So that's what we're going to do after these first three. And then you kind of land back on with your second finger on F and your thumb on G. You're going to make sure that second finger goes back to F before you play the thumb. Third finger is going to go to E before you play that F. And then before you play that E, put your second finger back. And then we're going to play this fourth, F, B. So you always have a finger on a string. Whichever one is next in line. It's like being on monkey bars, right? You always have to have one hand on a bar or you're going to fall off. It's the same idea. So I'm going to play that from the beginning of the tune. And the timing is this. The first two notes come on a pickup, so it'll be three and then you come in. One, two, three, 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2 and 3 and. And then you'll start it over on the 3. So the next phrase, again, is very similar. This time, you're gonna, again, land with your thumb on G and your second finger on F after you float it away. And this time, instead of going to the E with your third finger, you're gonna go all the way down to the D. But not yet. After you've played this bit, after you play the thumb, and before you play the F again, that's when your third finger can go to that D. So let's do that again, from the D, E, F. One more time. And this time, before you play that third finger, make sure your thumb or your second finger, whatever's more comfortable, is on that E. Because that's where you're going to end, and then you can float away. Alright, so we learned the first two phrases. This tune is a bit like a sandwich. We're going to play the first phrase. We get the different second phrase. Now we're going to go back to the first phrase. Exactly the same. And now we have a new ending. So you think of it as four separate chunks. First phrase, second phrase, back to the first phrase, new ending. Here's the new ending. So we're going to start with 3-2-1 on B, C, D. And here's a couple of different ways you could do the fingering. 3-2, before you play 1, go ahead and put 2 back on C. Now we're going to propel forward and just cross your thumb over before you play C. Cross your thumb to the B. And then you're ready to play B, A. Thumb will go back to C. Now C, B. So again, that looks like this. 1, cross, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. If you have done a little crossover work and you're used to using fingers 1 and 2 more so than 4, maybe you'll choose that way. That's the way it's suggested in the sheet music. If not, if you are comfortable using finger 4, you could try it this way. 1, 2, 3, before you play 4 on A, your thumb should go to C, C, B. So, 3-2-1, 2-3-4-1-2. So that's the other way you might choose to do it. And that is our final phrase of that section. I'm not sure if you would necessarily call this song an A with an A and a B section, but that's how I think of it. That's the A section. We have phrase, second phrase, back to the first phrase, and that ending. Now, the second section, like the B section, is really similar to that. Similarly structured, we're gonna have a phrase, second phrase, back to the first phrase, new ending. So let's learn that, and then we're gonna play the whole tune together. So the new B part starts up high here, kind of where we just left, B, C, D, and it sounds, first phrase sounds like this. So it's really similar to what you just played as well. And that's the second phrase. Also very similar to what you just played. So let's learn this one, the first one. 3-2-1. And if you're going to cross, you can do that here. Again, thumb to B. B, A. Thumb on C. And then you stack these three, C, B, A. Now your left hand can come take this F if you like. You can also, if you're gonna use your fourth finger, you probably won't need it. Two, three, four, thumb on C. And then you could go one, two, three, four. And that is almost like a scale down. You would just skip the G. The way I have it arranged for the easy, you can take that F with your left hand. You'll actually be taking it with your left thumb because you're playing a fifth here. But for now, I'm just gonna articulate it more nicely with my second finger. So again, that phrase. And then, very similar to it. So this time we'll leave off the F and that A. We're just gonna end on B. Now, you guessed it, we go back to the first phrase of this section. And there's our sandwich. Now we have the new ending. I think it's easiest to use all four fingers here, so that's what I have written down. But again, it's similar to what you played in the beginning. 3-2-1 on D, E, F. Make sure you put at least two back before you play your thumb. And then you can sneak these others on. 2-3, again before you play four, just put your thumb on. And then we'll surround the C. D, B. You hug the C. That's what I call that. That's the whole tune. Now here are some other suggestions. If you're more of an intermediate player, you might want to try some of these ornaments. And also, I'm going to show you just a slightly different timing that you could do whether you're beginner or intermediate. It is putting a dotted eighth note at the beginning, followed by a 16th note. So instead of a straight 1-2-3 rhythm, it sounds like this. And you could try that as well. That's how I usually see it notated when I was looking for this tune. So there's also one there on the F, rather than just, but you can play it either way, whatever you like. Let's now do some ornaments you could try. So that was just a little cut on the G to the F. An extra little G. So right before you get to that second F, you just quickly do another G. Before you continue on. Then you can put those anywhere you like. Something else you might try? There, a little turnaround. So you do an extra G and F on the way down to your E. So there's another cut from the D to the C. And these I have notated in the sheet music like that. So let's play through the whole melody slowly together. And I'll go ahead and do it up here. I'll do it in the suggested fingering for easy beginners, and then I'll do it in the lower octave. So we'll just play it twice through. One, two, three, one, two, three. Like a tutorial for the left-hand arrangement I have for this and the harmonies in the right, those are linked below. They are exclusive to patrons, and they'll also be getting a extra tutorial for simple harp and voice small harp version, so check the description for that. Thank you for learning this tune with me. If you liked it, please leave it a thumbs up or comment below and let me know. That helps me out and helps other people see this video so they can enjoy it. If you learned this tune and you want to share your version with me, I would totally love to see it. You can tag me on Instagram at Tiffany Harp and Song, or you could join my Facebook group and share it there. There's a link in the description for that. It's called Mastering the Celtic Harp. If you want to see more free tutorials for Christmas, click on this playlist right here. If you want to check all the extra things on Patreon, like the harp and voice version, you can click that box up there. And if you want to subscribe for next week's video, make sure you click my face up there. See you then. Bye!